The objective of this screencast is to show how to use block diagram algebra to bind the transfer function that relates an input and an output variable. We have a block diagram which is of a general feedback control scheme where we have an input variable of YSP, or the set point of our variable, and our output variable Y. So our goal here is to use block diagram algebra to determine the unified transfer function that relates Y to YSP. The general procedure for this is to start from left to right. So we'll start by looking at the summing point, which is right here. At this summing point, we're adding YSP and we're subtracting a term. To evaluate what this term is, we have to look at what's going on before that. To see that, we can look at our branch point over here, where if it's Y at the output, that means it is also Y at all points of the summing point. So what that means is the fact that Y comes down through the signal and goes through GT. So with blocks, blocks multiply. So therefore, this becomes Y times GT. So therefore, the value after our summing point is going to be a plus YSP minus Y times GT. It'll leave us with YSP minus YGT all multiplied by GC. We can take advantage of the distributive property and of the associative property to multiply through the other two blocks, which will come right here, and that will leave us with YSP minus YGT multiplied by all three of those blocks, GC, GV, GP. The important point now is that based on the summing point we talked about earlier, indicated by the blue arrow, we see the fact that this term YSP minus YGT times GC, GV, GP is also equal to Y. So with this equality, we can now begin to develop our transfer function that relates YSP, the input variable, to Y, our output variable. Here we will factor out YSP times GC, GV, GP minus YGT times GC, GV, GP will equal Y. The best way to put this equation in the terms of Y over YSP is to gather the Y terms on one side of the equation, the YSP terms on the other. So we'll move the second term on the left-hand side over to the right-hand side. The next step is we can factor out the Y of both terms. Our final step will be to divide both sides by YSP and by this 1 plus term we developed here. So when that is done, we end up with Y over YSP, our final transfer function, as GC, GV, GP divided by 1 plus GT, GC, GV, GP. This is a feedback control loop. This transfer function is also known as the closed loop transfer function. The GT, GC, GV, GP part is also often known as the open loop transfer function.